Are you videoing or something?
Yeah. Well, it makes your face like funny.
Are you videoing it?
Yes.
It's like cable guy.
Cable guy.
It's the cable guy. Hello.
I'm here.
I'm camera shot. I don't want to break your camera.
Here, look.
There hasn't really been any gigantic leaps in surfing as far as equipment and those sort of things for 15 years. I'm not sure where it's going to go from here because we have such small and light boards compared to the size of the guys. So from here on out, it's got to, maybe we can find some materials or something. Besides that, it's just surfing is kind of going more to the aerial maneuvers and taking from skateboarding, snowboarding, and getting a little more radical and difficult and technical. And so you have to sort of try to keep up with that. And that's really the advancements in surfing at this point. Plus, then there's a whole other thing with big wave surfing.
Yeah, I want to ask you that. What's the biggest wave you've surfed?
Oh, I don't know, probably two ceilings or so.
Twice as high as the ceiling.
Yeah.
Do you get frightened?
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah.
Give it away, son.
Yeah. Well, you know, I mean, when it comes right down to it, it's just a matter of holding your breath. So.
I found that. Yeah.
I mean, if you can hold your breath for a long time and you don't let the visual thing with the waves scare you.
Okay, take us through this. You're paddling out, and take them out by machine, but you're paddling out, and you get swept over by a wave, as I'm sure everyone who's ever been in the surf has felt this in about 3 feet of water. That feeling, just as you go down, what happens there, and what do you see?
You don't see anything. You just close your eyes. I mean, you can open your eyes, and you just see white water.
It's another dumb question, I can feel.
No, it's not, you know what I mean? It's definitely a serious question. You know, when you're dealing with waves that you feel are life threatening, you don't put yourself in a situation where you get sucked over by the wave. If that happens, you know, it's dangerous. So just try to stay away from that. I mean, big wave surfing is calculated. It's not like you just go out there and randomly take off on a wave. Like from the beach, it sort of looks crazy. You know, I mean, even when I watch big wave surfing from the beach, when you get out there, you get a different sense of what's happening. You have lineups on the beach, you know, you have 2 points that you line up, so you have a straight line, and you know how big the sets are, and you know where they break, and you know how many waves are in them, and where you can make the wave, and where you pretty much can't make the wave from. And so you're sort of calculating all that, you know, and then you have to trust your equipment, and you know, there's people there on jet skis or other surfers out there that are going to look out for you too. But you know, when it comes right down to it, no one can pull you out of it.
It's like a washing machine.
Yeah.
Past times, what else do you do? Surf?
Pretty much all I do is surf and golf.
Now, they're certainly not bad at the golf.
I feel right.
What do you play off? What handicap?
I'm about a 4 handicap.
Oh. Looks alright, he surfs, he's handicap 4 of golf. Tell me you're gay. Tell me something wrong with
you. Yeah.
Not yet? Chance. Well, there's a chance for all of you here. Right, switch. Music. What do you like in music? I read something here that might interest Christian people. Powderfinger?
I love Powderfinger. Yeah, one of my favorite.
Brisbane Band. Very good. What's the future? You've dabbled a little bit in soapies and a movie. Tell us about the movie. Come on, tell everyone about it.
I had like.
We've got Russell Crowe down here in America. It's got you. What was your movie career? Come on.
I was in a movie last year called One Night in Fools. When I was actually filming it, I had like two lines in the movie. It was this movie with Matt Dillon, Paul Reiser, Liv Tyler, John Goodman, all these. It was a crazy cast, but the story wasn't any good. Straight to video, but I think that wasn't my fault.
It wasn't a blue one, was that?
No, sorry. When we were shooting my scene, I had two lines, but then when I saw it on film, I didn't have any lines.
It's a tough business.
Yeah. Made the movie too long.
Yeah. Where do we go with the future? Once you stop surfing, what are we
going to
do?
I mean, my dream as a kid was to be a pro surfer and to retire when I'm done and have a family and a house and go surfing every day. So that's what I plan on doing.
Okay. And you are, I know, we're working on a video to teach people how to surf.
No, actually a video game for like PlayStation 2 and Xbox and Nintendo GameCube and all this stuff. About 3 years ago, Tony Hawk, who I'm sure a lot of people know that name, Tony Hawk, got a deal to do a video game with Activision. And he's had the top selling video game, I think, maybe ever. And so sort of the same thing, we're doing a surfing game with the same company. And
that's available for anyone to view?
Oh yeah, that'll be...
Where do they pick that?
I don't know, any kind of gaming stores or probably the surf shops too, I imagine. But
what are we calling it?
It's called Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer.
Okay. Another good question. I'm on a roll here. Kelly, you've got the tournament at the Gold Coast this week?
Yes.
Okay, what the guys who want to go down and watch you surf and learn how to surf, because I'm sure none of the women want to go down and see you at Skippy Togs or anything, what should they do to see you this week?
Well, I think the contest is going to start on Tuesday, given that we have good surf. So. We'll see. It's either going to be, most likely, either Burley or Kira. And Kira is my favorite place to surf in the whole world.
Really?
Yeah. I absolutely love the waves in the
world. Yeah, I must admit, I saw an interview with Kelly and he said, the Melbourne people, I love Bell's Beach, but...
No, I will tell, I've gone on record every year I've gone to Bell's Beach and said, I hate that wave. It doesn't suit my surfing, and I find it really hard to surf, and I struggle in competition there, but I've had a couple wins on the Gold Coast.
And that's a Quicksilver sponsored competition?
Yeah,
they've been right behind you?
Yeah, I've been with Quicksilver for nearly 13 years now, so, and they're sponsoring the event this week.
Well, Kelly, all the best, not only this week, but throughout 2002. We're very privileged to have you here at an AFL game tonight. World champion six times over and making a comeback now.
Thank you.
Well, I'm good, mate. So, ladies and gentlemen, just to remind you that you must have all the personal belongings with you when you leave the room. It has to be reset for half-time refreshments. Please feel free to come back half-time again after the game for a couple of drinks and a pie or two. No drinks
are in the function
room of our breathtaking outside. And make sure you take those tickets with you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the night. We wish the St Kilda Club all the best, but I think most of us here are cheering for life.
Alright, so what are you doing now?
Tossing the coin.
You're tossing the coin? Oh, cool.
Beautiful, man. Drop ahead of me.
That'd be a good wide angle shot from here.
Is it over?
I mean, just right here while we're here.
How long are we here for?
No, it's saying it'd be cool to be behind there where all the balls are flying in.
Yeah, it would be cool.
Thank you.
That's what I'm doing. Turn your phone off. Say nothing, but I just walk out. I'm with this guy. This is awesome. Look at this.
Go Lions, Richmond Lions. They kicked the winning score. They had some kind of anthem. I missed it.
I don't know what they're singing now. So try to kick it through the field, the goal.
Hard.
Is it a hard ball?
Nothing.
Damn, that is hard.
It's harder than what we have. Hey,
tell you that.
How was it? Hold on.
It was heads.
You're right.
I think I owe like 50 cents up there.
What?
It was heads.
It was heads? How was it?
Where did it come out?
Yeah. Just stay out here. Just stay out here.
Got it. To watch for. Did you get my bounce?
Yeah.
Did you hear what he said? He goes, if you can bounce, there's a chance I can serve.
Yeah, I heard him say that. I saw two. I just went out there and I said nothing.
You gotta try or you don't get anywhere.
Exactly. Hey, once they say something, I'll quit.
Red team? Red team's getting smashed.
After the sixth title, as some people might know, Mark, know the name Mark Richards from Newcastle. Mark had he had four world titles from 79 to 82. And when I tied that, I just wanted to kind of keep going and see what I could do. And he had four in a row, and I just set my sights on trying to get five in a row. And once I got that, that was really the pinnacle.
Six world titles, ladies and gentlemen. Would you please welcome Kelly Slater. Welcome to Brisbane.
Thank you.
You know Australia very well, but you don't know this great game so well.
I'll get a big lesson from there.
Yeah, and you have seen a game on television, I believe.
Yeah, many times.
Okay, a bit different live, it's quite spectacular. A bit different to grin on, you like that as well?
I'm not that used to grin, actually.
Okay, well you'll take the message back how good our AFL is after the night, I'm sure. Okay, six world titles. Why can't they win? Between us, yeah. I don't want to talk about it.
Are you videoing or something?
Yeah. Well, it makes your face like funny.
Are you videoing it?
Yes.
It's like cable guy.
Cable guy.
It's the cable guy. Hello, I'm here.
I'm camera shy. I don't want to break your camera.
Here, look.